Greetings, people. Paul Mucker here. Today is January 30th, 2013 at 2:16 p.m. Eastern Time. Now, people, the reason for this video here, right, is not to gloat, not to brag, and not to celebrate anyone's destruction. But this video is regarding the tornadoes, severe storms, that are wreaking havoc in the United States from yesterday, January 29th, to today and until tomorrow. Now, people, a lot of people think I talk a lot of mess, a lot of I don't know what I'm talking about, but it does take a lot to get me real angry. And as you all know, I've shown you all videos of when I'm angry at what can happen. Now, people, and January 28th at 6:08 in the morning, right? I released a video to you all saying, breaking news, I am under attack. Right? Because a video that I made and uploaded on June 4th, 2011 regarding tornadoes that struck Massachusetts because of what they...
This is the second time I have busted them tampering with my videos.
People, on June 4th, 2011, I uploaded a video because about tornadoes, real tornadoes that struck Massachusetts on June 1st, 2011 because the federal court made a bad ruling against me. And I was angry, and because of my anger, two tornadoes struck Massachusetts. Real tornadoes, because Massachusetts doesn't get tornadoes. So, my friend, someone sent me a message, and as I told you all, I went to check, and I found out that they cut my video short because a video talk about tornadoes when the federal court make bad rulings. And people, I made a video because they cut my video short. The video was 9 minutes and 11 seconds long. And he spoke about tornadoes, real tornadoes striking, and about the federal court making wrong rulings against me. And because of that, tornado struck. And people, they cut my video short, make it from 9 minutes and 11 seconds to 4 minutes and 41 seconds. Because in this video, it showed the truth that Paul Mucker know what he's talking about. That when these honorable men make wrong rulings, with my spirit, if I so choose to, if I get out of control, not if I choose to, but if I get out of control, that my spirit could cause tornadoes and severe weather. And it happened on June 1st, 2011. It was also a sign about my rights, I mean, that I was right about what happened on 9-11, September 11. So it was a double sign. So the point being, June 1st, 2011, the federal court made wrong rules against me to give my house away to the banksters and to give George Bush and Barack Obama victory over me, and two tornadoes struck Massachusetts. And January 28, 2013, they came to shot my video to make it look like I was making threats to them and to hide the fact that Paul Mucker can cause tornadoes with my anger. Well, that when they make wrong rulings, I could cause tornadoes. And people, how is it that in this new video that I made, right, I'm speaking about telling my Lord to kill them because they're tampering with my videos. And in this video, I'm showing tornadoes. In this video, I'm showing tornadoes. Hold on, give me a second, because it's very important. It has to do with what's going on in America today. You see that, people? In that video, how is it that in that video I'm talking to my God to take revenge for me? I'm asking my Lord to take revenge for me in this video. I'm talking about tornadoes. I have tornadoes, right? You see that? And that happened on when? June 1st, 2011. Then on January 2013, the federal court made wrong rules against me also. So the anger was bubbling up. And then they had the audacity to come and cut my video to hide the fact that they're cheating. So, my friend Benito said, H. Paul, you have done well. You have stood up for your rights and the right of all others. It is now time for you to give it to the Most High, our power and rest. Him, he knows the nature of these evil, wicked beings. They are not real human, but aliens, humanoids. They feed off the blood and the energy of humans. This battle belongs to the Most High, and he will not fail. Babylon will fall. It is time to get out of Babylon, America. Get back to nature and pray and meditate one love. And yes, my brethren, Ben Israel, I did give it back to the Most High. I gave it back to the Most High. Right? And what's happening? Well, that's the second Most High. You know, the Son is the Most High. Asa is next in line. I gave it back, right? And what's happening down south? What's happening in America right now, my brethren? This is rare. It's winter time. They're not supposed to have tornadoes and those kind of fluctuations in the weather, right? No. You know what it is? It's my anger. I've given it back to the Most High. So now, sorry for the victims now. Even my family are in the path of this destruction. Sorry for the victim now. But when the rain fall, you don't fall on one of my house top. When you all push me to the point of anger, don't think I'm going to come out and stalk you all, go look for guns and shoot you all. I don't go to schools and shoot up little kids. I don't pick up guns and shoot senators, and I don't try to assassinate nobody. That's not the kind of anger that Paul Muckle have. I don't carry that kind of anger. My anger is I put it in the law, the Most High. That's where I put my anger. In the sun, in the universe, okay? So when you all want to take me to court, when you all want to prosecute me, I'm going to tell a jury that Paul Muckle is an angry black man. The jury is going to laugh at you all. They're going to laugh at you all when they realize that Paul Muckle's anger is in nature. I don't need guns. I don't need bombs. I don't need to the hypocrisy to kill you all. All I have to do is pray to my God and ask him to kill you all. That's what I do. That's my anger. That's how I do it. I don't go shoot up kids in school. That's not me. Okay? I don't do those kind of stuff. And I sure hell don't do false flags and have little kids murdered just to push my agendas. Okay? I know you are a secret. Okay? That's why I upload that video on December 12th. I upload a video about get ready people, NWO, that's what the video was about. I knew what was coming. I didn't know it was kids. But I knew there was going to be something dramatic and shocking was going to happen. I even wrote someone and said, people are about to die. And he better pray to God that he's not one of them. So the point being, I know you are secrets. I know you are false flag secrets. Yo, Sandy Hook was not, I don't care what nobody says, Sandy Hook was not no random act. That was straight up set up. Just like these suicide bombers in the Middle East, they are all set up. It's to push these guys' agenda. And then you all want to prosecute me? I can't wait to face the jury. I can't wait to show the jury your dirty secrets. So the point being,
look at that key, bro.
My anger is wreaking havoc down south. Because that's where your stronghold are. Down south. That's where your stronghold are. Okay? Babylon throne. So if y'all want to mess with me, and when you all want to make wrong rulings in the federal court against me, when you all know I'm right, I send the tornadoes down south, and I'll march them up north and up the east coast. I don't need weapons. Okay, I don't need weapons. My Lord is my weapon. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He make me lie down in green pastures. So, anyway. Here's the rest of the news. I want to show you guys what happened down south, okay? So, my friend, be vigilant. okay? Be vigilant. But when the rain falls, you don't fall on one man house top. So if y'all wanna mess with me and make wrong rules against me, the thunderstorm gonna crack up your whole kingdom. Alright, here goes the rest of the video.
So this tornado here that you're looking at leveled a small home, flipped over some 10 cars. One person died there after a building collapsed. And a man, we're also told, was killed in Nashville, Tennessee, where a tree fell on his home. You're looking here. Look at all the colors, the warnings. We're going to talk to Chad Myers here in a minute. But I want to get straight to Miguel Marquez. He has hopped on the phone with me from Adairsville, Georgia, just about 60 miles north of Atlanta. So, Miguel, we saw the picture here of this tornado. Tell me what you're seeing on the ground right now.
A wide swath of damage to Adairsville, it looks like, for the most part. There is a hotel that's been shredded by this storm. There's a Daiki plant that makes heavy machinery. It's been shredded by this tornado. There are several businesses along the Adairsville Highway just off I-75 that have been damaged. There are power lines down throughout the area. Trees are down, smashed into cars, trailers overturned, trailers damaged as well. We've seen a couple of neighborhoods where there is some fairly significant damage to trailer homes. It's not clear where that person died, but it's not very far from where I am right now. It is still raining very hard here. The rain has been consistent. It's let up just a little bit. The other thing that's interesting, we left Atlanta about 45 minutes ago, like an hour ago.
Yeah.
The temperature is about 66 degrees there. It's dropped to 58 here, so we're getting into that zone where you get these temperature changes, and it's a dangerous situation out here. We heard tornado warnings and the sirens going off as we drove up here. In Marietta, there was tornado warnings and sirens going off. People throughout this area spending much of this day in their basements. It is a very, very frightening day in this part of Georgia right now.
Miguel, do me a favor, hang by, stay on the phone, because I want to ask you about these reports of people who are trapped. But Chad Myers, let me just hop over to you here. Tell me, because I got the note from you and the weather folks. I mean, this isn't just Georgia. I'm looking at Tennessee, Alabama, Arkansas, Indiana, Kentucky, affected by some kind of weather.
Yeah, about 1,000 miles north to south. And yesterday it was Arkansas, Missouri, back in Oklahoma. And that weather that was here has now charged to the southeast into very what we call juicy air. It's hot, it's humid. And if it's hot and humid where you
are,
you are still in the danger zone. Storms can still be coming to you tonight, because that's anywhere from eastern Pennsylvania, even into parts of New York, all the way down into Florida, and the cold air is on the back side of it. Let me show you the drastic contrast from 11 below zero in Minot, North Dakota, right now, to 78 above in Miami, 70 above in Atlanta. So from Minot to Atlanta, you're talking 81 degrees to Miami. Look at that, 89. I mean, literally, you get up into Canada, you're talking just across our continent, North America, 100 degrees from the coldest spot to the warmest spot. You can't have that kind of contrast without something breaking. And today, what was breaking
was
the weather. Here, I'm going to zoom in for you here, because this is where we're most concerned still. Weather coming into Atlanta, Georgia, all the way up here, the tornado watch box, all the way up to Winston-Salem. As far south is just about the northern part of Florida. So a wide swath of severe weather still potential for today, Brooke.
So, Chad, let me just actually read an email. One of the associate producers on our team, here we are, Atlanta, world headquarters of CNN. And so as this is happening basically in our neck of the woods, one of the brothers of one of the folks on my team, you know, actually wrote in and said he's working in Alpharetta. This is part of greater Atlanta, if you don't really know, our neck of the woods. And he said that the sirens are going off at this huge corporation he works in, just to echo sort of what Miguel was saying, all these sirens going off because there are fears that tornadoes are approaching. And he told us everyone was told to move to the center of the building, and to quote this email, he says, everyone is freaking out. Can't say I blame him. Chad, I have more for you in a minute. Miguel Marquez on the phone with me from Adairsville. Miguel, back to these reports of people trapped. Do we know where they're trapped? Are they still trapped?
We don't. I can tell you, we've just pulled up to the Daiichi plant, and it is demolished. There's a bank right next to it. This is a north side bank. The roof has been completely taken off this. There are lines down everywhere. There is a fire hydrant that has been taken out, and a stream of water shooting up maybe 50 feet at the plant itself. Much of the plant destroyed. It is absolute destruction here. There was a hotel called the Relax Inn that was damaged very badly. It could be that some are trapped there. I understand that most of them, if not all of them, have gotten out. They apparently have also gotten out of this plant belt. Okay, but looking at it now, it's shocking. I don't understand how they could get out because it is, there's nothing left. It is a pile. It's a pile of rubble at the moment with only part of the building left standing.
And you mentioned is the Relax Inn. Miguel Marquez, we're going to come back to you. Hopefully we can establish a picture from you. You can talk to some of these people as far as what they felt, what they saw. Miguel Marquez Forrest in and around Adairsville, Georgia. Miguel, thank you. Chad, really now to the big question, the why. I mean, you look here across the country, folks are seeing, you know, winter one day and spring the next. Take a look with me and you're going to see here.
It's my anger.
Topeka, Kansas. People are out and about playing, record high there, about 77 degrees this week, 69 degrees yesterday.
My emotions.
Spring, but now, 27 degrees. People are freezing temperatures there, and the hot and the cold temperatures, they're really what's triggering this violent storm system, like the one that has many on alert in Georgia right now. And like this, look at this.
My emotions.
Winds in Texas, tumbling.
Like a woman in labor.
About everywhere. This is Midland, Texas. And then we have this video. This is from Tennessee. Look at what remains. A roof.
My anger.
Here because of the extreme winds. Roof after roof after roof. Homes flattened. And a 47-year-old man, as we mentioned at the top of the show, killed in Nashville when a tree fell on his home. Chad Myers, let me just bring you back in. Because as we talk about this, it's like an extreme fluctuation in temperatures, right? Well, why?
My emotions.
It's because the jet stream has dipped from the north to the south. And if you remember where we were at this time last week, the dip, this cold air was in a different spot. The dip was over the northeast and people were going, oh man, it's cold. How did it get so cold so fast? And then this dip moved into the Atlantic Ocean. Everything moves from west to east. It traveled across and now it's cold in the Atlantic. And so now all of a sudden the jet stream is dipping to the west, that's why the cold air is here, but it's rising up over here into Canada, even warming parts of Newfoundland, all the way up here to Nova Scotia, and that's allowing the warm air to get here. When it's warm and muggy in Winston-Salem or Columbia, South Carolina, like it is right now, on a winter day, something is about to break, and that is the break is the cold front. You will see storms and thunderstorms all night long, showers even all the way up even into parts of the northeast that could be heavy enough to cause flooding. It's one of those days where there's so much moisture in the air, the cold air won't let it stay in the air. The cold air pushes into the warm air. The rain and the humidity in the air has to fall out. Some of it goes up and makes thunderstorms. Some of it just makes flooding.
Chad, don't go too far. We'll continue talking. We'll continue looking at pictures. We'll talk to Miguel Marquez. And also, we've got a tornado chaser coming up at the top of the hour, so don't go anywhere here. But let me get to this. Developing right now, all eyes on the Dow.